The Philippine Health Department, meanwhile, reports 7 more firecracker-related injuries Wednesday, bringing this year's total to 32. That's a 39% jump from last year. Acting Health Secretary Maria Rosario Vergere reminds the public those injured should immediately seek medical assistance and get tetanus shots to prevent infection. The price of onions in Metro Manila markets has ballooned this holiday season. The Agriculture Department says a kilo of onions now costs around 500 to 600 pesos. The agency cites the increase in demand and high farm gate costs for the rise in onion prices. The DA sees no need to import onions yet, since the harvest season will begin next week. For now, it plans to provide transport subsidies to farmers so onions can be sold at 200 pesos per kilo at Kadiwa stores. The Philippine government could have done more in taming inflation. That's according to Ibon Foundation's executive director, Sonny Africa. In a bid to cool down inflation this year, the Philippine Central Bank raised rates by 350 basis points since May. But Africa says hiking policy rates had been harmful for low-income households.
The biggest problem with using interest rates to control inflation is that they were trying to do the textbook manner of repressing aggregate demand to sort of reduce inflationary pressures. There are two problems with that. One, by focusing on repressing aggregate demand instead of improving supply conditions, it didn't really address the problem. Secondly, it actually creates new problems in terms of lower levels of economic activity and employment and incomes, which means that especially low and middle income households without savings would actually be in a harder position to deal with rising prices of goods and services.
Over 100 passengers stranded at a Cebu port as rough seas due to the low-pressure area prompted trip cancellations. Several thunderstorm warnings were issued since last night. Local government units there were also told to prepare for heavy rains. Port authorities warn there may be more canceled trips in the coming days if the LPA intensifies into a tropical depression. Over in northern Samar, search and rescue efforts for two missing fishermen are hampered by the continuing bad weather. Local officials say the two went missing after they set sail on December 22nd. Aside from rains, the huge waves also make the operations difficult for rescue personnel. Families of the two fishermen hope their missing relatives could still come home alive. A massive relief effort underway in flooded areas in northern Mindanao. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has ordered concerned agencies to provide all necessary assistance to affected communities. More than 100,000 families from various regions were affected by the intense rains and floods during the Christmas weekend. The death toll is now at 25. 26 more remain missing.
Search and rescue operations po natin para dito sa mga nawawala ay patuloy naman po, no? At nangunguna po dyan yung mga kawinin natin sa Philippine Coast Guard dahil karamihan nga po ito, ito yung mga isla at nawala po sila sa ating coastal areas.
According to the OCD, floodwaters in at least 15 areas have not receded. In Misamis Occidental, where a state of calamity has been declared, at least one resident says they have not received any help from the local government.
As of the moment po, wala po kaming kuryente at tubig at wala pa rin pong tigil yung ulan since Saturday po. Nakaka-receive naman kami ng relief through our friends, pero from local government, wala po kami na-receive.